Hello everyone, welcome back to sedochealth. I'm Dr. Job Dodge. This is a platform where you get to ask all those biting questions concerning your health and you are duly answered. A lot of questions have come in, but this one stood out. I don't want to get pregnant. How do I calculate my safe days? Welcome back to the channel. Today, my colleague Dr. Dan Sechunga will help us understand how to calculate the safe days.
Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Dan and I'll be taking you through on how to calculate safe days. This will help us to hit two birds with one stone, as it will help couples out there that are trying to have timely sexual intercourse so that they can conceive. Now, in a female menstruation cycle, we have what we call a fertile window and a non-fertile window. The fertile window is that part where a woman is more likely to get pregnant. A non-fertile window, in brackets safe days, is when a woman is unlikely to get pregnant. A woman ovulates about 14 days before her next cycle. Cycle length is a period of time from the first day you see your period until the first day you see your next period. Say for example, a female that had her period on 1st of January and she had her next period on 29th of January. 1st of January is her first day of that period. And 28th January is her last day of that period, meaning her cycle is 28 days. Therefore, 29th January becomes her first day of her next cycle. So for such a female, her ovulation will occur 14 days before her next cycle. So that is 28 minus 14, which is 14th day. So for example, for a female with a 30-day long cycle, ovulation will still occur 14 days before the period. So that is at day 16. I've gotten that by doing 30 minus 14 to get 16. Let me also remind you that a male sperm takes about 5 days to die off. So this sperm can stay in a female for about 5 days, camping there to wait on fertilization. Now that means for a 28 cycle from about day 10, you are unsafe. The female ovum will also have a lifespan of about 24 to 48 hours. Again, you are unsafe from day 15 and day 16. What about for a 30-day cycle? We have said ovulation will occur on day 16. Therefore, unsafe days will begin from about day 12 to about day 18. Let's also note that most females will never actually have exact days of the month every month. You find that most females will have a cycle length that varies between 21 to 35 days, which is normal. It is difficult for such a female to follow such a calculation. And that brings to me what we call a calendar rhythm method. This will help you calculate your irregular cycles, but it will need you to first track your menstruation cycle for the past 6 months. So you'll get the longest cycle of the 6 months, then the shortest cycle of the 6 months. We're going to do some mathematics so you can get your pen and your paper. So what you do, you get the longest cycle. Say for example, it starts at 3 and you subtract 11 from it. So you get 22. I'm just giving an example. Then you get the shortest, maybe it's 26. So you get 26 minus 18 and therefore you get 8. Meaning for such a female, her first fertile day is on day 8 and her last fertile day is on day 22. Our next example is on a person with a 30-day cycle as the longest and a 25th-day cycle as the shortest. So we shall get 30 days minus 11 and we get 19. Then we get 25 days minus 18 and we get 7. Meaning for such a person, the answer from day 7 until day 19. We talked about something we call timely sexual intercourse, TSI. TSI is very important and is a first line treatment for patients that are struggling to have children. So for a couple that is trying to have a child, you can have sexual intercourse between day 7 until day 19 if your cycles are between those days I've mentioned above. I had a couple I saw some years back, and this lady had difficulty conceiving. So I explained to her about timely sexual intercourse, and I told her she needed to have sex between day 7 to about day 19. This lady lamented and said, "Me, I cannot have sex every day with my husband." It is not a must that you have sex every day for you to conceive. Research has shown that having sexual intercourse every other day also has good results in helping a couple conceive during timely sexual intercourse. Calendar rhythm method has an accuracy of about 80%. However, its accuracy increases to almost 90% if it is used in addition with other fertility awareness methods. Fertility awareness methods include tracking your cervical mucus discharge. We said that around ovulation, the cervical mucus discharge increases in amounts. The basal body temperature can also be monitored. A day before ovulation, you'll have a drop in your body temperature and will start increase from ovulation going onwards. The woman's sexual drive will also increase around ovulation. So once you combine these signs together with a calendar rhythm method, you can have a very good result. So to recap this for you, self-days are part of a female menstruation cycle. They can be calculated as long as you monitor your periods very well. We have said you need to track your periods for about 6 months to get better results. Your partner also needs to be very cooperative, as you may need to abstain in your fertile days or use protection.
So, we have known the how to calculate safe days. Thank you so much for being with us today. Remember, like this video, share it with your friends, but remember to subscribe. Press that notification bell so that every time we upload a new video, you are in the know. Sedochealth, ask the doctor.